Hey everyone, welcome back to the bandwagon. We're going to talk about modern this week. This is more of a modern check-in because we, you know, spoilers, don't think there needs to be urgent action on modern. In fact, don't think it's all that likely something happens soon.
Yes.
But the modern metagame is in a pretty interesting place right now.
Yeah, and so I think I should actually start this episode with a little mea culpa.
Oh yeah, we were going to get to that, don't worry. Yeah. I guess you can kick things off.
I think we can just fire it
off. Look. Here on the bandwagon, I promise you, if we get something wrong, we will let you know.
Yeah.
Because when we get something right, we're going to brag about it.
Oh yeah.
But the flip side of that is, well, it is right now, Matt.
Yeah,
Ness.
So in one of the previous bandwagons, I talked about unbanning Stoneforge Mystic, and well, I'm still not sure it was a great decision or that it will be net positive for modern long term. It is pretty clear that Stoneforge has not been too much for modern for the moment, and in fact hasn't really been showing up all that much. And so I didn't want to take this time to apologize and say
You don't have to apologize.
Just say I was wrong.
Yes, exactly. You just have to admit you were wrong.
Yeah. And so, here we are. I was wrong. Stoneforge Mystic hasn't been doing all that much. I guess most mid-range decks do play Stoneforge, maybe.
So I've been playing a lot of Modern recently. Yeah. I know you've been playing a little less because of the Mythic Championship, but
right.
I've been playing a ton of Modern, and there are blue-white Stoneforge decks are good.
Yeah.
Mono-white Eldrazi Stoneforge decks are good, and black-white, which are similar to Eldrazi, kind of disruptive Stoneforge decks, all good. And some people were playing the Urza Stoneforge decks because it can get sort of the meek, but Paradoxical Outcome has kind of replaced those decks.
People
as
just
the best
aren't
Urza
even
deck.
Really playing Thopter Sword with Urza too much.
No, why Thopter Sword and you can just kill them?
Yeah.
You draw your whole deck. So, yes, Stoneforge Mystic, definitely on the scene, definitely an impactful card, but definitely not ruining it either.
And maybe it is homogenizing the mid-range decks a little bit, that it is still maybe doing that to some degree, but definitely my prediction was wrong.
Yeah.
And so...
But so what is good in Modern right now? I know what I think is the best deck, and if there were any action, this would be first on my list, but I don't think anything needs to happen.
Yeah, so Paradoxical Urza is the deck.
The combination of Urza plus Paradoxical Outcome means all of your zero mana artifacts tap for mana, then draw you a card, and then you get to play it again, trigger your Scythe and Saheelis. Emery is a huge new addition, because not only is she a 1-mana 1/2 that taps to replay an artifact, she also makes it so Mox Amber taps for mana, and it kind of all feeds into itself, where Mox Amber helps you cast turn 1 Emrys, and then lets you play turn 3 Urzas. Been testing Oko in the deck, too. Not sure on that one yet, but it actually seems pretty promising.
Yeah,
so.
It's definitely a useful sideboard card.
The two most dangerous cards in the deck, I think, are Mox Opal and probably Paradoxical Outcome. There's an argument for Urza as well, but my guess is, first of all, nothing's going to happen in the near future, and nothing should happen. I mean, these cards, from a monetary perspective, Mox Opal is just worth so much, it would just be such a disaster to get it banned. Like, we can talk about gameplay implications as if there were no secondary market factors, but the truth is, I don't like when people get their decks banned out from under them. Like, we talk about bans from a perspective of like, hey, what would make the metagame better? And in some cases, sure, I think there are some people who, you know, got their KCI deck banned and were sad about it, and I sympathize with them. Mox Opal's just in a completely different realm.
Right, a lot of people have made the comparison between Mox Opal and Faithless Looting. They're both busted enablers for different decks, one for graveyard decks, one for artifact synergy decks. But there's one big difference, and it's the $100 price tag on Mox Opal.
Yeah, so, yes, when your Faithless Ludens got banned, your Phoenix deck became unplayable.
Right.
But guess what? You had a bunch of Scalding Tarns and Steam Vents, Snapcaster Mages, you know, what have you, Thing in the Ice. Like, maybe you can't play Arclight Phoenix quite as effectively, but you can make a red-blue deck and these cards still retain their value.
Yeah.
If Mox Opal got banned, it would plummet. I mean, it would still see play in Vintage and Legacy, but nowhere near these levels.
Yeah, so then out comes a possibility, but it was possible the best deck in Modern before was Mox Opal Urza with Thopter Sword, so you could just go back to that, and that might still be the best deck, and it's always awkward when you ban something, and basically the same shell is still the best deck, so that's a tough one.
It would be like if you banned, you know, Stitcher Supplier, and then Hogak was still running rampant, or if you banned Rid from Below, and Hogak was the best deck.
Well, yikes. So then there's Urza itself, which is another option, but that one's also pretty expensive, and it's also from Modern Horizons.
And it's a cool card.
It's awesome.
like you can debate whether you think Mox Opal's cool or not, or just a busted mana accelerant.
Yeah.
But Urza's awesome. Urza's a really cool card.
Yeah. It's first of all, just the existence of an Urza card is really cool. Yeah. And second of all, the design itself is pretty sweet.
Yeah, it's really neat. I have the games I've enjoyed the most with the outcome are not the turn three outcome games. Kills. It's exactly. It's when you have Urza and nothing else and you're just like using it five mana, you know, playing a card, et cetera.
Yeah. So I don't really know what to do here. It was like six of the top eight at the SCG or something like that. It was a pretty high ratio and I was sitting next to Josh McLean playing the deck and it seemed pretty busted to me. It is hard to play, so you know, there is that. But it may be in the KCI category of like incredible, very fast, some turn three, a lot of turn four kills, while being incredibly resilient. Urza, Saheeli, Sai are just gonna, when you board in your Stony Silence Collector Oof type stuff, and you just get Urza, Saheeli, Sai, it's
Urza
pretty,
does not care about that. Yeah, the artifact's still tap for mana.
It's pretty demoralizing in some ways, I think.
Yeah. So right now, I do believe that Outcome is the best deck. I don't think anything should happen to it. And so besides that, I mean, Burn's actually seeing a bit of success in Modern right now.
Yeah.
I think that the blue-white Stoneforge deck is pretty good.
Yeah.
I'm not sure exactly where Jund is landing these days. It's feeling like, because of Outcome, Jund is getting pushed out.
Yes.
Traditionally, Jund is good against like combo decks, but the Outcome deck is just so resilient. And especially the addition of Mystic Sanctuary, that's a big one.
Yeah.
We hadn't talked about that yet. That's the land from Eldraine where it's an island, which means you can fetch it, and then if you have three other islands when it comes into play, you can put a spell from your graveyard on top of your deck.
Yeah, you know what's good against Thoughtseize? Top decking.
Right, and you know what? When all your polluted deltas turn it in and flooded strands turn into outcomes, like you're not going to beat them by Thoughtseizing them.
Yeah, so it's a tough spot. I find it frustrating when these like super powerful synergistic decks, the heat doesn't work, and we might be in that place now. I think
KCI was like that a little bit, right?
It was similar.
Where you could board in a bunch of hate and KCI was actually like a solid grindy deck.
But Stony at least was actually effective.
Stony was excellent.
Stony, Urza gets around Stony because the Urza is the one using the mana ability. Right. So even that's not, I think Chalice of the Void is the best hate card against them.
But if you don't have it on turn one, it's a lot less effective.
There's hate cards like Nature's Claim and Oko. So it's tough. It's a very powerful deck. It's not obvious how to interact with it. Maybe faster combo. And that concerns me. So I kind of would lean towards banning something, except that I have no idea what I would ban.
About this. The bandwagon is issuing an official warning on the Urza Outcome decks. We'll see where they land. All right, now we think Modern's in a pretty sweet place, but we definitely got our eye on Urza Outcome.
I also did want to make a quick PSA on Urza Outcome, which is win conditions. I feel very strongly that the most common win condition I see in these decks is Nexus of Fate, and it's a loser. You don't really use the instant speed part of the card. You don't really use the shuffle in part. If you wanted, for some reason, to take an extra turn, I believe it should be Time Warp, honestly. But also, why? Just use Grinding Station that works super well with Urza, or use Mirrodin Besiege that's like kind of like a Sai Saheeli card, and you can just explosives away all your artifacts, use the Phyrexian mode, you can bounce it with Outcome to reset it, and use that as your win condition.
Yeah, so
Mirrodin Besieged or Grinding Station, both acceptable.
Play Nexus.
No Nexus.
All right, that's it for the bandwagon today. We'll see you next time.